Assalamualaikum and good morning. Okay, so basically today we are still under oral communications topic. Okay, so basically, do you still remember what have you learned in the previous class? Monday, what did we learn?
We learned about interrupt.
Interruptions. Yes, we covered that last Friday, and then last Monday. It's actually how to take turns and how to give turns to others, and then definitely your gestures. Okay, your gestures and facial expression. Okay, why is it important to use gestures and facial expression? Is because you need to emphasize on certain point. Okay, you want people to hear you out. So somehow there are things that you want to emphasize. What is emphasize? Not just explain, but you want to stress on something. You want to stress on something. That means the maybe the significant points that you are trying to highlight. Okay, so basically today we are going to continue with ask for, give suggestions and make counter suggestions. Okay, so when a person gives a suggestion, doesn't mean that you just have to accept the suggestion, but you can always counter if you feel like it's not a good idea, or if you feel like maybe your idea is slightly better, okay, than his or her. Okay, right, and then you are able to respond to suggestions. Okay. So basically, today's class is on making and responding to suggestions. Okay, so basically, what do you understand with suggestions? Okay, good. Giving ideas or opinions. Responding to suggestions? Is it summarize the point?
Agree or you agree on the
suggestion. Exactly. Whether you want to accept the suggestion or you want to refuse or counter the suggestion or decline the suggestion. Counter suggestion?
We need to give our opinion based on his.
You counter suggestion is you try to refuse his or her suggestion while giving another suggestion. Okay? So that's how it goes. Okay, so example. Okay, giving suggestion. What would you say to a cup of coffee? Okay, and then another person. And then the response is no, thanks, I don't drink coffee. Okay, what about going to the cinema tonight? Sorry, I'm busy tonight. Okay. Somehow, is it polite? No thanks, I don't drink coffee. Okay, somehow it's good that it has this polite refusal. For example, no thanks, sorry, but somehow it's not really impolite, but somehow if you want to refuse someone's suggestion, perhaps you can come up with a better reason. Okay, better reason. So perhaps switch on the aircon. I think the remote is over there. Can you take a remote and then Archit, you can just help us. Up to you. All right. So perhaps this one is slightly better in terms of the structure. Okay. I would rather have tea than coffee. Okay. And then I would love to watch a movie with you, but I have something to do tonight. Instead of saying sorry, I'm very busy tonight. Okay, like. Who are you? I mean, you think you okay, right? So somehow this is more polite. Okay, and then perhaps another suggestion. Perhaps you can watch over. Sorry, we can watch a movie over the weekend. So that sounds like a good idea. So somehow, maybe tonight only she will be very busy, but during the weekend she's free. Okay,
cool.
Okay, another suggestion here. Don't you think it is good idea to have Fahmi's birthday party tonight?
Oh, no.
Okay. No. Alright, and then some people will say, why not? Fahmi will be thrilled. Okay, will be very excited. And then perhaps you might want to invite someone. So you ask for another, you give another suggestion. Couldn't we invite Miss Nurul to the party? Okay. So somehow sure it's a great idea.
Okay. Is Mira and Zahira?
Yes, it's Amira and Zahira. Two girls over there. Okay. They are so happy to throw a birthday party for Fahmi.
Yeah.
Alright. But so definitely when someone gives a suggestion, it is up to you whether you want to accept or refuse. Okay, so this is the structure when you want to accept. You can say yes with pleasure. Or why not? Okay, or what a good idea. Okay, what else?
That sounds like a good idea.
Yes. And then?
Yes,
I would love to. Or yes, I would like to. And then?
Yes, I do.
Or maybe, yes, I do feel like taking a walk. Yes, I do feel like going to the cinema tonight.
Yes,
so on and so forth. Okay, how about refusing? That means you want to say no. What would be the polite expressions?
No,
I would rather not, since I'm very busy with the preparation for my wedding reception, for example. Okay, no, let's not do that. I don't think it's a brilliant idea. I don't think it's a good idea. I dislike going for a walk. Maybe somehow, yeah, maybe he or she prefers to jog rather than walking. Okay, I would love to, but sorry, I cannot make it. That means you're unable to somehow to be that. Sorry, I don't feel like going. Maybe you got flu, you got fever. Okay? Right. Okay, example, this one. I think that 17 is too young to drive. What do you think?
No.
Did you drive when you were 17?
Yes. I think 16. Yes,
but 16 you cannot drive, right?
Yes,
the car driver's license. But 16 you can get the motorcycle, motorcycle license, but not for driver's license.
Illegal way.
Illegal. Okay. And then another person says, excuse me, that may be true for some people, but many 70-year-olds are very responsible. Maybe a few are careless. Okay, yeah, not everyone. Only for me. Okay. Well, yes, I know. What about the teenagers? They should not be allowed to drive. They are very dangerous and they might kill. Okay, this is like a very harsh statement, right? Okay, if I could just come in here, that means interrupting, if I could just come in here, I see what you mean, but I don't think that it's right to punish everyone because of a few people's mistakes. Okay, so somehow that is how you, when you make suggestion and you counter suggestion, you give your own opinions and ideas. Right, okay, that's it of making suggestions and counter suggestions. So what have you learned? How to give suggestions, and then in terms of accepting suggestion, whether you want to accept or refuse the suggestion. Okay. Right, so basically you have learned how to ask for suggestion, give suggestions, and make counter suggestions, and straight away you know how you respond to suggestions. Okay. That leads to our second input for the day, which is very, very important for your assessment, group discussion. So basically, you have learned everything, all the skills of making clarification, asking for clarifications, agreeing, disagreeing, making interruptions, politely, what else? How to make inquiries, right? How to respond to inquiries, how to make suggestion, how to counter suggestion. And this would be, I would say, the thing that we can assess you on. Whether or not you are going to apply all the skills that you have learned in this group discussion assessment. Okay, so what is a group discussion?
A group discussion is...
Zahira, what is a group discussion? Okay, what your opinion before we go into detail?
Group discussion is...
Are you Zahira? what do you understand with group discussion?
You don't know.
Mm, yeah, your own opinion.
Discussion for me, remember mm-hmm. about the topic mm-hmm. that lecture gave.
Mm-hmm.
So
everyone ideas.
Okay, is it what lecturer is giving you? No. Any kind of topic, right? Okay, do not specify it to our assessment. A general group discussion. Okay, group members talking about a topic among them, and then
Opinion.
Giving opinions and then hearing other people's replies, okay, and so on so forth. Okay, basically, your opinion towards something, okay, to be shared with everyone, and then because we are individuals, right? Different people, different brains, different understanding, different perspective. Different perspective. So when you discuss a certain topic, you might get different opinions. Okay, somehow they might agree with you, they might disagree with you. Okay, right. So basically, a group discussion is a group activity carried out by participating individuals and exchange of ideas among these individuals on a specific topic, which I'm going to give you later. Okay, so why is it important?
Exchange.
Because you can exchange ideas and opinions of a topic, and then to argue and debate of the issues. You know, because some people sometimes, you know, they have this tunnel vision. It's like they think that their opinion is the best, whereby they wouldn't really accept other people's opinion. But somehow, when you discuss about something openly, okay, you tend to exchange ideas, and then you start to ponder, oh, okay, I think your idea is good. Somehow you try to be more open, okay, open. And then it is for you to find solutions for problems. Okay, definitely when you discuss about something, you are able to get some answers to overcome some problems, maybe to, for example, how to organize, you know, class trip. So maybe like you don't know where to start, but when you discuss among your group members, you manage to know, you know, where should you begin, who's going to handle this, who's going to handle transportation, who's going to prepare the food, and so on so forth. Okay, so parts of a discussion. What we should have, definitely, you start the discussion with greeting. Okay, you greet. And then, after you greet, you initiate the discussion. What is that? What do you understand by that?
Initiate.
What is initiate?
Starting the discussion.
Like you start off the discussion. You try to start the topic. Okay? And then, maintain the discussion. What is that? It's like, this is the part that you involve everyone, and then you give turns and take turns. That is the part that you maintain the discussion. It's not like one person just, you know, at the corner, saying nothing, just feeling. Like what?
Datuk Mika.
Datuk Mika? Okay. Why is it?
You know them.
So somehow, when you maintain the discussion, you get to involve everyone, okay? To say something, to throw out some opinions, and so on and so forth. And then, after you have discussed, you know, for maybe for about 10 minutes, you start to end the discussion. Because, of course, discussion will not take forever, right? Okay, because you have other things to do. So, after you have ended discussion, you are able to find maybe the solution, the best way, the best remedy, the best way to achieve happiness, the best way to go to Pangkor, maybe, okay, the best way to save your money, and so on so forth. So what is essential in a group discussion? What is essential?
potential.
What is essential? It is very essential for everyone to do this.
Yeah.
Very important.
Important.
So what is important in a group discussion? Definitely the strategies, people. Because 20 marks is it a lot?
Yeah.
A lot. In order for you to get, you know, in order for you to score for this group discussion, you have to have these strategies. So what are those strategies? A series of planned actions to achieve an aim. Okay, what are the aim? I mean, what is the aim? Okay, for that group discussion. So basically, you plan for the movements of an action. So what are those things? How you introduce the topic. Okay, the second strategy. How you ask for and how you provide information. Definitely, when you involve everyone in the group discussion, you give ideas, you accept ideas, you disagree on certain ideas. Okay, you give suggestion, you counter, you counter suggestions, and definitely in the discussion, when someone disagrees with you, when someone is ready to share his or her opinion, they will interrupt. Okay, excuse me, I don't see eye to eye with you. Okay, I'm sorry, I beg to differ. That means I want to give another different opinion here. Okay, so basically those are the strategies. And then you make conclusions. Okay. So how do you introduce the topic? Definitely in the group discussion, one person will have to initiate. That means we'll have to begin. Yeah, we'll have to begin the discussion. Because four persons, right? Definitely one of you would have to start the discussion.
Yes.
Okay. So this morning, we are going to talk about, you can use that structure. Okay. Today, we will be discussing on how to lose weight. Okay. Such a controversial topic. Okay, the topic of our discussion is how to maintain a healthy lifestyle.
Yeah.
Okay, example. So shall we start the discussion on how to improve our communication skills?
Yeah.
Okay, example. So let's start with let's start with Bismillah. Okay, let's start with breaking the ice among us. Maybe you talk among ice breaking. Okay, you want to break the ice. Okay. Strategy 2: asking for and provide information. Shakirin, yes, you didn't get what does it mean by break the ice? Okay, you see an iceberg, so cold, right?
Yes.
So firm, but when you break the ice, it
melts.
Yeah, it somehow it melts. Okay, it breaks up. It's the same with when a group of, you know, group members. Okay, so somehow to break the ice, you can start off with the small talk. Hey, you just finished your class? Okay, have you taken your lunch? Okay, so somehow it's like to get familiar with other group members. You start to have small talk first. Then only you jump to the topic.
Yeah.
Okay, so strategy 2: you ask for and provide information. How to ask for information? Definitely you can use the WH questions and other inquiring techniques. Remember, you have learned polar question, where you ask questions and the answer would give whether yes or no. Okay, do you always go to Padang Polo, you know, for jogging? No, not really. Yes, I do.
Severally.
Okay. Is it severally? Seldom. Jarang-jarang. Okay. Asking for information. Do you know that Malaysia now is one of the, the top 5 countries that would have problem with obesity? Example.
Okay.
What is your comment on this? Could you please explain when you said that?
I'm totally disagreeing.
Could you please explain on this?
Why?
Sorry, but can we get more details here? So you are going to use this technique. You ask for information. Okay. Can we look further into this matter? Because your opinion just now, you were talking about blah 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 blah. Okay. So somehow these are the structure that you are going to use. Okay. What else? It can be seen that, okay, the reasons are, Okay. The benefits are
such as
one of the most important aspects is okay. I would like to add what is said by Daniel just now. Okay. Perhaps we need to consider Amira's opinion just now. Okay. So those are the strategy. What else? Suggest? Suggesting. Strategy 3. What do you think?
What do you think?
Harjit, what do you think of this opinion? How about you, Danish? Okay, would you agree with me? Okay, my view is that teenagers shouldn't be allowed to drive until they have reached 20 years old.
Yes.
Okay.
I'm not agree.
It seems to me that nowadays youngsters are too focused on technology.
Study.
Okay, I tend to think that we can achieve happiness with giving others. It could be in the sense of donation, you know, or charity. Okay, countering suggestions. I think your idea is good, but let's hear out from my opinion. Let's hear out my opinion first. Okay, that's a good way to see the problem. However, if you look at another angle, something like that, okay, you may be right, but somehow, Hanapi's idea is relevant in this context, something like that. Okay, I see what you are saying, but perhaps there are many problems that might happen if we do your way. Okay. I understand your concern about the topic, but somehow you may seem to forget that the reality, you know, la 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 la. Okay, it depends on the topic actually. Okay, strategy 4, you will interrupt. Okay, interrupting. Excuse me, can you please repeat what you have just said?
Are you there?
Would you say? Excuse me, are you there? I'm sorry, I'm not quite clear what you mean by giving charity to others. Okay. Allow me to interrupt. Is it good to... allow me to interrupt, but is it a good way to organize a campaign for those who are obese? May I add something here? Okay, because I can see your point is good, but somehow I would like to add, you know, some more points relevant to the suggested idea. Sorry to interrupt, but I have to say this. Okay. Okay. Last one, making conclusion. So this is the part you put an end to your discussion. If there is no objection, this is supposed to be I apostrophe D. I'd like to suggest that I would like. Okay, it's the abbreviation form to I would like. Okay, if there is no objection, I would like to suggest that Shakirin's point would be the best method to reduce weight.
Yeah.
Okay, so yeah. So if all of us agree, we can decide that Fahmi should lose some weight. Okay. Our unanimous decision is okay. Unanimous means two of you maybe agree on something, another two of you agree with something else. Okay, that means you don't get a mutual agreement. Okay, we all agree that Fyrul's idea would be the best. Is the best method to improve on language proficiency. Okay, now we can conclude that. Okay. Who else? Sandeep's idea would be the best solution. Okay. Would be the best solution to overcome financial problems.
Overcome the high percentage.
Alright people, do's and don'ts of a group discussion. What are the do's and don'ts? Do's, the things that you should do. Okay. A group discussion is your chance to be more vocal. Okay, the evaluator wants to hear you speak. Who is the evaluator? Yes, that would be me. Okay, so seek clarification. If you have any doubts, you can subject. Meaning when you get the topic, somehow you don't understand, do not be afraid or don't be shy to ask the lecturer, to ask me, perhaps, what does it mean by this? What the question is trying to ask, okay? Your body language says a lot about you, okay? I think I have highlighted this, your gestures. Gestures, facial expressions and mannerisms are more likely to reflect your attitude than what you say. Because sometimes you may, you know, show your sour face, you know, like, you don't have, yeah, when you disagree. It's good when you play with your eyebrows or something, but do not show your negativity, you know, negative mannerism. Be assertive but not dominating, meaning if you want to stick to your point, that means you are trying to highlight that your point might be relevant to the context. You try to be assertive but do not dominate. Don't try to dominate the discussion, like the whole time you want to speak. Okay, try to maintain a balanced tone in your discussion and analysis.
Okay,
so work out the various strategies just now to help you initiate the discussion, okay, or agree with someone else's point and then move on to your on to expressing your views. Okay, what are the don'ts? Do not try to be someone you are not. Be yourself. Yeah. What does it mean by this? Sometimes a student is trying so hard to sound like an American or trying so hard to be a British. Okay? So you use the British accent. Because it will sound awkward, and then you might not feel at ease, okay, when you deliver your points. Don't start speaking until you have clearly understood and analyzed the subject, okay? Do not lose your coolness, meaning if anyone says anything you object to. For example, I don't quite agree with you. I think your point is quite irrelevant or not relevant. So somehow you don't feel like, don't show your
anger.
You know, somehow you try to show your emotions. Okay, don't do that. Do not take the discussion personally. Yeah. Because it's an academic discussion, right? So you should chill. Okay. So avoid using extreme phrases like, I strongly object or I disagree. Maybe, well, your point is good, but somehow I would like to highlight my point. Something like that. But for me, it is fine if you use a proper tone. For example, well, I think I would have to disagree with you. Something like that. It's not a problem if you use I disagree. But maybe you want to add some polite expressions before that. I think I would have to disagree with you. Okay? Instead of trying to use the phrases like, I would like to share my views on, or one difference between your point and mine, or
I beg to differ.
I beg to differ is not a problem, basically. Yeah. Instead, try to use these phrases. Okay, somehow those phrases are, how to say, it shows your positive personality. Okay, I would like to share my views on. One difference between your point and mine is, I think my point has a positive side towards losing weight. Okay, of course it has to depend on the topic. I beg to differ with you, but somehow I think in this context it is quite irrelevant for us to save money for the program. Example, okay. Okay, that's all so far. Any question?
No.
I'm going to share these slides with you on the WhatsApp group.
Cool. Thank you.
Right, so basically that's pretty much about
the group discussion.
What topic is now? Counter suggestion and
making
suggestion and counter suggestion, and the last one is
interrupt.
Are you sure? What have we learned? The big umbrella of group discussion. How you involve in a group discussion.
How you want to start the discussion.